a lottery per stare. We'd be in fine fucking ugly right now. You got 95% of the battle over with, you know. And that's why most of these comics with nice frilly shirts and lovely suits and good looking. No fucking chance. No chance of making it whatsoever.
Good evening! The reason why I'm coming out early, because he said to me, try to stage out for weight, because he's a big fat bastard, this is coming on now.
I went to the Isle of Man one time, there was a comic on, an alternative comic on before me, and he got pelted with fucking beer cans, like, you know. I walked on, there was 2 feet of beer can, I'm studying them like telling jokes, quieting them right down, all the bikers. They know what they like, you can't kid people. Some of these bikers and all these people that's worked hard all week, you can't con them.
In this business, you've got to have talent and you've got to have guts. And I mean it sincerely. And in this business, you've got to have good looks and you've got to have guts. And this bastard's got a lot of guts. He's the fattest, I'm not going to say nothing, but put your hands together and welcome on the stage tonight to the Embassy Club, the one and only Mr. Bernard Manning!
George. What a lovely fella. Yes, it's me, Bernard Manning. Lost fuck all on the slim back plan. Not a fucking ounce. Lovely to see you all anyway. It's a wonderful night tonight. It's going to be great tonight. Manchester City's doing well. This will be on the tape. It won't go up for 5 fucking years. Them 2 old girls in the corner there. Are you all right, girls? I bet you're flattened a bit of grass in your time, you two, haven't you? Hey, bet they see more ceiling than Michelangelo, them two. You'll enjoy yourself tonight, don't worry about that. What's her name in the corner, that little old lady? Alice. She looks in fucking Wonderland, she doesn't. Are you all right, Alice? Now, what about this little trainee corpse on the front here? Is he going to fucking last while the end of the show? How are you? I wish you could fucking hear this. It's funny, believe me. I wish you could hear it. He thinks I'm fucking singing this old fella here. You don't believe it. Was it cold in the ground this morning? Say hello to Roy Orbison when you get back. Tell him what I'll do. You look fucking poorly to me old pal. You're not holding a Christmas tree, have you? Throw your fucking money away. And don't go out on bonfire night, the kids will fucking sling you. Gentleman with a little red jacket on there, there's a child crying in Chalet 14, if you like to go on. I've never worked in front of a fucking mounted policeman before. Aye, that's what it's all about. Fellow walks in the Chinese chip shop, he says, hey you. He says, how do you know my name? What about the Irish fellow went to a car boot sale, backed in the wrong way and sold the fucking engine? Unbelievable. Come in, love. Oh my God, this massive cheese with him, she's nice. How do they fucking get him? I don't know. I could have her tonight, you could fucking hang me in the morning. You Japanese never fucking love, do you? Hey? And I forgot Pearl Harbor, pal, don't fucking worry about that. The fucking shit house trick that was. December the 7th, 1941, you fucking lousy bastard. Look at him sat there, he can't wait to get home and make another Datsun. You look a nice young fella, don't piss on this fucking job over there. Bastards. This Negro went to Birmingham, Alabama, he says, to vote, like, you know, and this state trooper said, said, what do you want? He says, I've come to vote. He said, there's no Negroes voting today. He said, I can read and I can write, so I've come to vote. He said, can you write? He said, I can. He said, got a piece of greaseproof paper and a fucking biro pen. Put your name and address on there, he said. He said, I could write when I left home this morning, he said. He said, I'm still voting because I can fucking read, he said. He says, can you read? He said, read that fucking Jewish Chronicle. He said, I don't know what the small print says, but the headlines are, there's no Negroes voting today. Irish fella, on the top of this blazing building. The fireman shout, jump in the blanket, Paddy, jump in the blanket. Not fucking likely, he said. You English, you hate the fucking sight of us, he says. I'm jumping in no blanket. I'll jump, you pull the blanket away, he said. Put the blanket on the floor, then I'll fucking jump, he said. Henry Ford came to Liverpool, and this fellow went to see him. He says, you Henry Ford? He says, yes, I'm Henry Ford. He said, is it right you can make a car in 3 minutes? He said, I can make a car in 2 minutes. He says, I know, and I fucking got it and all. Three admirals talking, English admiral, an American admiral, and a Russian admiral. And the Russian admiral said, I can show you courage, Russian courage. Ivanhoe, go to the top of the mast and throw yourself down for the Soviet Union. And up he went and killed stone dead. Russian courage. This American said, I'll show you courage, United States courage. Kalowski. Oh, call Kalowski, aren't they? I wonder who the president is this week. They keep fucking shooting him, don't they? It's a funny country, I mean. Should never have impeached that President Nixon. They should have had that Teddy Kennedy drive him home. Kalowski! Get in the plane there, fly around 3 or 4 times, scratching the seat of the good old United States. Up he went, meow. Kill stone dead. United States, keep quiet, lads. I was like that after my first pint. You'll get used to it. You don't really want to bandy fucking words with me, do you? The good old United States courage. This English admiral said, look here, you guys, I'll show you courage. English courage. Seaman Smith, come here. Yes, sir, he says. Get in the 17-inch gun there. We're going to fire you at the beaches there. Splat your innards all over the beach. For good old Great Britain. He says, get fucked. He said, how's that for fucking courage? Certainly. This little kid said to his dad, where are you going out again, Dad, tonight? He said, I'm going fucking. He said, can I come with you, Dad? He said, certainly. They get in this back garden wall there, and the big cat goes, meow. Fucking big load of tin cans, water, shit and all sorts. Come on, he said, we'll go next door. Sits on the wall, meow. Fucking eggshells, tin cans, fucking beans. Come on, he said, we're going on the club roof over here. Load of fucking water. Oh, shit and everything. Fucking hell, he said. One more fuck and let's go home. This nigger walked in this pub with a fucking big parrot on his shoulder. And the barman said, where have you got that from? And the parrot said, Africa, this fucking hell. Two Irish fellas used to knock about with his packy, and the packy got knocked down, killed stone dead. The copper said, what was his name? He said, we never knew his name, sir. Just used to booze them, you know. He said, where did he live? He said, no, we knew fuck all about the man, he said. The only thing we knew about him, he had two arseholes. He said, how do you mean? He said, every pub we went in, they used to say, here's that packy with them two arseholes. Two Irish fellas walking through the Vatican, one said, you see that fella over there with the crooked stick and the mitre cap? I think that's the Pope. He said, I don't think it is. He says, I'm sure it is. So I'll go and ask him. He went up, he says, are you the Pope? He says, fuck up. He went back, he said, what did he say? He said, he wouldn't commit himself. Should have been here last night, woo, had a bird on here last night, a stripper, did this splits over a Guinness bottle. Cost a fucking fortune, lost 14 cases of Guinness up to now, fucking Thursday. That's me shaking hands with the Queen backstage on the Palladium, Royal Command performer, me, you know. You know what's in him up tonight? He was with her, the Duke of Kent. What a gormless bastard he is. Oh, Mr. Manning, laugh my bollock off right here. Now, Princess Anne, you want to see her close up? Fucking hell, like shaking on your head, bro. Have a lot of trouble, the royal family, you see. They're getting in the real world now, you see. I'm firing Windsor Castle, all that fucking whinging and whining. It was fuck all new in there, it was all on gear. You weren't having the fucking house, I'm that stuff. They said it was a discarded fag that started the fire. Prince Edward said I had fuck all to do with that. Nothing's the same anymore, you see. Everything's changing. Used with the Duke of York had 10,000 men, now he's a fucking duchess. Now she's opening Buckingham Palace to everybody. Them scousers will strip the fucking place. Be fuck all in there for Christmas. I can see it now, the Duke of Edinburgh walking down the... Where's that fucking table gone from there? You can see it, can't you? £50 million pictures on the fucking wall in Bootle and Birkenhead. Look what I got for your birthday, love. Fucking unbelievable, them scousers, aren't they? Eh? Unbelievable. And don't only you younguns out there ever believe what the Australian Prime Minister said about us. He's a cheeky bastard, him. If we let him down during the war, nothing could be further than the truth. Nothing could be... We stood alone in 1941. They all fucked up and left us. The French were the best. It lasted long in the World Cup. We didn't fucking war the French. And that was a fortnight long of the Dutch. One Wednesday afternoon they fought, 3-4, fucking turned in them. They were throwing fucking tulips. We don't forget, I'll tell you. Someone's old as me will tell you what we went through in the war. Fucking awful. All the shit we read of Australia. Neighbours and fucking Skippy. You remember that Skippy? A kangaroo driving a fucking dick. They must think we're fucking mental, them people. Ron Farris, what the fucking hell can that man do? My mother thinks a painter decorator. Ooh, there's some shit in this business, you know. Hale and Pace, how the fucking hell they get away with that? They've just solved the mystery of the Marie Celeste. They found out they were the fucking cabaret. Lovely to be with you anyway, it's nice this. Fellow went to the dentist. Start that again. Fellow went to the dentist, he said, what price do you charge? He said, well, we've got three such charges. He said, there's one for £7,000, he says. No blood, no pain, beautiful teeth. He said, we've got one for £2,500. He said, that's just a little bit of blood and nice teeth and just a little bit of pain. He said, what's the cheapest? He says, 40 quid. He said, what's that? He said, loads of fucking blood, pain, fucking awful teeth. That'll do, he said. I'll send a wife tomorrow morning. Two little lads talking once said, my dad's fast. He said, fast? How do you mean? He says, he can catch a bullet in his teeth. He said, that's fuck all. He said, our old fella's faster than I. He said, he works for the corporation, he said. Marvellous, he said. Don't finish while five, he's over fucking three. Well, I went to Blackpool, he said to this donkey fella, he said, how do you train a donkey? He said, I'll show you, he said. Got a fucking big plant. Got this donkey there, he gave me a crap right over the fucking head. He said, what have you done that for? He said, well, first of all, you've got to get their attention. There's a fella riding through with Ireland with on his donkey, and his wife's walking behind. The copper pulled him up. He said, could you tell me, he says, why are you riding that donkey and your wife walking behind him? He said, well, that's dead fucking easy, he said. She ain't got a fucking donkey. Couple of our Indian friends on the front row. Nice to have you with us, me old son. Hey, who's manning the fucking shop? Oh, bloody hell. Lovely. They're all right, there's nothing wrong with them. They come in quite regular, these two lads here. Smashing, they've been after a job for a fucking wage of a long time. They're fucking judge you, you know what I mean? Anyway, nice to have you with us, me old son. Don't come again, just for tonight. All right, you're all right. Don't mind fucking once, but don't make a habit of it, you know what I mean? This time last year it was pissing down with rain, unemployment, soaring, no light at the end of the tunnel. It was fucking awful this time last year. Robert Maxwell joined the Drifters? What a crooked bastard that fella. They released the hostages anyway, that was a good thing. That Jackie man looked fuck when he come out there, Captain. Fucking hell. I think he'd just give her one before he got an upset. Rather than me, any fucking hell, tell you. What an ugly bastard, that one. I should have fucked the little dog she used to carry back. Some ugly bastards in this world. I know a bird that was so ugly she used to vibrate a piss. And then Maxwell Brothers, they'll get away with that, you know, they got the right man on the job there. George Carman, fucking genius, that man. Never lost a case. Got Ken Dodd off, Len Fairclough off. Millions for that, Richard Branson. Millions for that airline, the Virgin Airlines. He was coming over Ireland in that balloon, saw an Irish farm. He says, Where am I? He says, you can't kid me, you cunt. You're in that fucking basket. Hey? You never could pick Ken Dodd in Liverpool. You're looking to get a fucking jury together. I might convict him. I like to go to Liverpool once a year to visit my fucking hubcaps. What a piss all of a fucking place, that is. There's that many houses boarded up in Liverpool, the fucking window cleaner's got a sander. I went to see City play just after last Christmas. We drew one apiece, little Scouser come up at Anfield. He said, can I mind your car, mister? I said, no, there's a fucking Rottweiler in the back of there. Oh, he said, he can put fire out, can he? The doorman worse than a kid. What a nasty old bastard. Something upset him, like having a go at everybody. Straight through Mr. Manning, he says, enjoy the match, pulling his fucking face. Zeb Coe's behind me, not in here, he says, not this gate here. Not this gate here, right round the other side of the park. He says, I'm Zeb Coe. He says, well, it won't take you fucking long. A scouser went for a job on a building site. The foreman said, what would you want to pay that 80 foot chimney? He said, 80 foot fucking brush. Scouser got for a prostitute. She said, would you like a blowjob? He said, will it affect me dough money? Irish fellow went for a job on a building site. He said, what's your name? He says, Paddy Mulligan. He said, how do you spell it? He says, stick the job up your arse. You gotta be fucking cooking here, you know. Dozy bastard. Irish fellow walking up pub, he says, orange drink, please. She says, still orange. He says, yes, I've not changed my fucking mind. This packy went to this bank. He said, I want a cash check, please. He said, oh, quite all right, sir. He said, sign the back. No, he said, I don't want to sign the back. I want to sign the front like the white men do. He said, sign the fucking back. He said, I want to sign the front like the white men do. He said, well, you better sign the back. I'll go in the bank across the road, he said. Stormed out, went in this bank across the road, he said, I want to catch a check, please. He said, sign the back. He said, I want to sign the front like the white men do. I said, don't fuck me about, pal. Sign the fucking back. He said, I want to sign the front like the white men do. Pull him over the fucking counter, he said, sign the fucking back. Get it fucking signed. He signed the back, he gave him the money. Went to the bank next day, the first bank he went to, he says, I got that cash for that check. He said, you signed the back? He said, I did. He said, I told you not to. He said, yes, but you didn't explain like the gentleman across the road. I've got an Indian lives next door to me, you know, what a cheeky cunt. She says to me yesterday, I'm a better man than you. I said, I never said you fucking wasn't. What makes you think you're a better man than me? He says, I've not got a fucking Indian living next door to me. There's a dog fucking this fella's leg. And he went, fuck off. And it was a Doberman, oh right, nasty bastard. He said, we'll only open them. That's what it's all about, a good laugh. They can't stop us laughing. Where are you from, son? must be Irish, you don't fucking know. Where you from, son? Where you from? Harper, are you here in Manchester? Are you a City supporter? Oh, we're having a rough time, aren't we, just at present? But never mind, son, he'll come again. They got the crowd to autograph the fucking ball the other night. Well, it's fucking awful down there, you know. We can't keep managers. We auctioned two balls here the other night. One was signed by all the City players, the other signed by all the City managers. The one who won the player the ball said, the goalkeeper's not signed it. I said, no, but he got his fucking fingers to it. You know what we're doing now? Putting the numbers on the front of the shirt so they look as though they're attacking. United just made a video, the 100 best goals. We just made a video, the 100 best fucking throw-ins. Houses in black and white. See, we like this out of City supporters. We knock ourselves, you see. You could never change us, because we love our team, but you could never change us. An American came to Manchester, he said, could you tell me the way to Manchester City football? Straight down here, me off, you can't fucking miss it, he said. You'll see two queues, a big queue and a small queue. Don't go in the big queue, that's your fucking chippy. We had a manager, John Bond, what a shit house he was. Left us halfway through the season. I wouldn't mind, he was the only one fucking scoring away. Took his son with him, Kevin Bond, what a lot of crap he was. If he took 12 shots at John Lennon, he'd be alive today. Now there's a fella, John Lennon, he wanted peace, he's fucking got it. You can't get any quieter than that, can you? He managed a Japanese, don't they, them slant-eyed bastards. What they did to our troops during the war, unforgivable. Starved them to death, humiliated them, give them dogs and rats and all sorts of shit to eat. Teddy Waite, he had a fucking picnic in there, towards what they were doing. Tied to a radiator, that I loved a fucking radiator. They fucking at it. All the lovely girls we've got, he's got to marry a fucking job. What was her name? Oko Poko or some fucking nonsense. Yoko Ono, that's it. Right, ugly bastard. Face like a blistered piss pot. You won't remember piss pots, will you, son? Very happy days they were. You didn't know they was full till your thumb got warm at the top. They were the happy days of the 30s. We had fuck all, but we was happy. We had doubt. Everybody was poor in them days, I'll tell you. In the 30s. I had a pair of shoes in 1934, the fucking soles of that thing. I could put my foot on a penny till it was head to tails. But never try it out because nobody had a fucking penny. Hard times. So I think my mother was a ventriloquist, you should say. Get in that fucking house. No, you little bit. Get in that fucking house. Let's have a smoke, eh, love? Let's get nice and homely down here. Lies a fag. Stop me having cans, I'll have it for you. Fuck Roy Castle. He's getting some fucking mileage out of that, isn't he? No, we do until he stops fucking smoking. Hey? Eh? Give him 6 months to live, he said, I'll do it in 4. Do you know that 100% of non-smokers fucking die? If you like a smoke, have a smoke. If you like a drink, have a drink. If you like chips, have chips. If you like bread, have bread. Take no fucking notes of these specialists. They'll have you in bed for 7 o'clock. Drink and drive if you want. There's nothing worse than having a smash if you're fucking stone cold sober. The copper says, all the back end's hanging off. He says, I don't give a fuck. When the police pull you up, you know, they must caution you. Remember that, they've got to caution you. They'll say to you, you're not obliged to say anything, but anything you do say will be taken down and used in evidence. Your next sentence must be, please don't hit me again, officer. I bet that Teddy Waite won't go again in a hurry. I bet he's home to stay, that nosy cunt. He was fucking warned not to go, he was. I'll have my bollocks up when he got captured. Can you imagine Archbishop of Canterbury now? Would you like to go over to...
For coffee.
Send some other cunt. You wouldn't know, wouldn't you? It's all right sending other people at it as long as you're not fucking going. Do-gooders, you see. The world's full of do-gooders. Had a mate at school like that. Always fucking busy he was. He went to Africa to help the hungry. And he fucking edged him. I mean, all them Ethiopian children needed was Lenny Henry and his fucking big fat wife going over there and showing them what it looks like to eat 10 meals a day. That's all they fucking need. I bet when he looked at him, they thought it was good. Them people want milk and cheese and butter and eggs and blankets and money. Not fucking sightseers watching them starve. This scruffy country, I don't know. There's enough grease on them trousers to make a pan of fucking chips. How do they get away with these youngsters, I'll never know. I bet the best place you had your money in your house under the fucking soap, innit? Lovely. That's what it's all about. The fairy godmother said to Cinderella, if you're not in here before 12 o'clock and I ball tonight, your fanny will turn into a pumpkin. Well, she's down to this big handsome bastard here. What's your name? He says, Prince Peter, the pumpkin eater. Time you got to be in, 6:30. I walked up to this woman in this pub, said, I'd like to fill your fanny with draft guineas and suck the lot. She ran up to us and said, you know what he's just said to me? He'd like to fill my fanny with draft guineas and suck the lot. He said, if you think I'm tackling a fella that can suck 28 pints of draft guineas, fuck you. And I walked in this brothel, and I've only got a tenner. She said, there's nothing here for a tenner, son. Not unless you have the penguin. He said, what's that? She said, go room number 7. She'll explain. Dolly bird. Absolutely delicious. Come in, she said. He said, well, I've only got a tenner. I've come for the penguin. She said, give us the tenner. She stuck it away. He said, what's all this about a penguin? She said, oh, you'll be very satisfied. Don't worry about that, she said. She unzips his flies, drops his ketch round his handle in his underpants. She walked away. The music struck up. She stripped off slowly. Gorgeous, absolutely. He stood there with a right fucking stand up ladder. Defying gravity. She walked back, she could only be like that, she went like that. With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. And he's just about to shoot, and she walked away. He says, where the fucking hell are you going? This fellow walks in this pub, he says, what do you want, a pint of bitter? He said, there, my old pal. He's halfway down the rash, he said, aye, £1.50. He said, I got a bit of fire with you, mate. He said, you fucking what? Have you got no money, you? He said, I won't. You cheeky cunt, get away from the body. I'm now ready to go back. Hey! Oh! Fuck off, he said, you're not on it. You fucking had one. He said, you come me once, he said. Think it is? I said, fucking hell, he said. He said, I'll toss you for one, he said. Shout out your tail, he said. Fucking full moon tonight, they'll be bouncing off the fucking walls in Rampton tonight. There's no chance of giving you one, is there, later on? You think you'd be fucking grateful, though, wouldn't you? No fucking oil painting. We've got a few fellas enjoying themselves tonight. Nigel, come up here, my old son. Let's have a word with you, Nigel. I believe you're celebrating something. And where's Dave? Dave Paris? Nigel, come up, son. How are you?
I'm all right, how are you? Yeah,
lovely. Somebody's pinched the bulge out, you know. What a fucking weirdo, you. What's the bulge now, are you? What's your name?
Dave.
Dave Paris. Nice to meet you, Dave. Nice. Very smart. You're taking a piss with you. Seems like you just knocked on the back of a fucking nurse. us up here.
Mike.
Are you Mike? What's happening with you, son?
Who are you?
What's happening with you?
Birthday, mate.
It's your birthday. Happy birthday. And I hope you'll be very happy all the rest of your life. I can't fucking see myself, so I'll
thank you, sir.
Where are you from anyway, son? Where are you from?
Northwich.
Northwich?
Yes.
Nice place to come from. No fucking good to go to. You're very welcome anyway. What are you celebrating? No school in the morning, are you?
Thank you very much.
Well, them's your first teeth, them, aren't they?
Yeah.
Well, you're fucking lucky if you don't stand over there and keep fucking still. You stand over there on that line there. Thank you. You fucking dressed, you look like a fucking scarecrow. Sorry, the fucking I thought you'd come to light the fucking bar when you first walked in. You could fucking own houses, you know, doubt about that. What do you do, Nigel?
I'm a sales manager.
A sales manager?
Yeah, I am indeed, yeah.
Oh, my God. You couldn't sell life belts on a fucking sinking ship. What do you sell?
Motor cars.
Motor cars? What kind? Not them fucking Japanese dog.
No. Volkswagen Audi. Gilbert Lawton, come and see us.
Gilbert Lawton for the Volkswagen. Gilbert Lawton. Mine! Everyone! What are you? Und Deutschland! Ein Volk! Ein Reich! Ein Führer! He was fucking calm, that poor bastard. He sat in that bunker and turned out the gobbles, he said, I think we fucking blew it. And the Germans are bashing, what they done now, you that film Holocaust, release it in Germany, go out the good old days. Well, you've been very good, lads. We're going to sing Me and My Shadow now. Dead easy, this. You know this one? Oh, Me and My Shadow. I'll prompt you. And fuck you, pal, as well. I'll get you on the way back. Don't you fucking worry about that. You make a good burglar, you. Your ass is in your footprints out.
Me and My Shadow.
Well, I hope you fuck, mate, you sing.
You should know.
I got a fucking tire going now, that
you should know, Billy.
Strolling down the avenue.
Not bad, that. Don't fucking worry about that.
Me, we wanna be together. We wanna walk in a garden.
I don't give a fuck about the garden. How about that?
We wanna be together.
That's the best fucking advert I've ever seen, that. She's looking at him as though he's fucking mental. And when he looks like that...
Strolling down the avenue.
You're not fucking quick, are you?
I'm glad you want to know.
Remember Rock Hudson, fuck it up. You should think he was fucking marvellous, him big macho fella, and then he'd see him in the fucking paper like that. All alone, and give a nice round of applause, everybody. Yorkshire Minor went over to South Africa for a job. He said, these credentials, we couldn't fold these. It's people like you run over here. We have a lot of trouble with the blacks. He said, well, we've got a few in York. He said, it's not the same from it. He said, we don't fucking bother them. He said, what do we do then? He said, well, I'll give you a bit of a test. There's a revolver. Go and shoot six niggers and a rabbit. He said, what have I got to shoot the rabbit for? He says, you've got the fucking job. Hold that door, John, there, will you, son? Let a bit of fresh air in. Get the air conditioning on, son. That's right. Let that fucking dragonfly out now. Okay, lovely. It's dark outside, you know where I fucking know it. Lovely. Just get some nice little cuckoo layer for it. When you heavyweight champion of Belgium, do you want to war, son? Fucking hell. Lean on him, you cut your fucking self. Excuse me. Where are you from, anyway?
Middleton.
Middleton? Oh, it's very posh up there, isn't it? My word, even the fire station's ex-director where he comes from. Oh, you ring up and say, who recommended us? Oh, them fucking teeth, I bet you need to tomatoes with a fucking tennis racket with them, can't you? Fucking hell. Something like that fucking has to do. Not fucking no, you got the fucking lot, you. Okay, hey, you know, I bet I'm fucking nearer than you, give it up. Well, I've seen some ugly bastards in here, but you've chopped the fucking bill. If you get a fucking here tonight, the chance for all of us. Got Gary Glitter here last week, left one of his bollocks, look at that. You know what my ambition is? To go live on the Antique Roadshow and say to some old woman, you know that's worth? Fuck off. Not a fucking comic. Now fuck off with it. That'll liven Sunday up, won't it? You better listen to that Harry Seacombe, that screeching bastard. Never told that man he could fucking sing, I don't know. 40 years you put up with that bloody nonsense. Ever see him on the highway, I'll knock the cunt down, I'll tell you. Fucking hell. Like a fucking wine, innit? He's not been well, you know, Harry Seacombe. I might get that job. I'd be all right going around them churches and them great vicars, wouldn't I? Which him would you like? Oh, him. It's one thing I couldn't be fucking queer, I'll tell you. I couldn't stand fellas refusing me as well as women. That Freddie Mercury had a full show at Wembley for him, a full show. He had to bury him on his hands and knees so his fucking friends would recognise him. The dirty bastard. Elizabeth Taylor, she gave a speech at the show, she said, don't have too many partners. Elizabeth Taylor. She must be due for a fucking rebook, that woman. These plenty of people telling you how to live your life, you know what I mean? Of course you see what I talk about, don't you? Why don't you see what I talk about? Fucking shit house. The plane crashed in Madrid about 6 months ago, 200 Japanese on it, broke my fucking heart. That. 6 empty seats. His doctor said to this fella, now I've got good news and bad news. He says, what's the bad news? He says, you've got AIDS. Fucking hell, he said, what's the good news? He says, you've got Alzheimer's disease, you little fuck all about it, have we? Fella went to the doctor and says, I've got a mole on the end of my prick. He says, drop your kicks. He says, well, I can get the mole off. He says, but I'll have to report you to the RSPCA. What about the fella broke into Ratner's jewellers and stole the fucking carpet? Posh fella stood at the bar with this working lad. He says, I bought my wife a Mercedes yesterday and a Rolls Royce. The Mercedes to knock about town and shop and the Rolls to go to Ascot Newmarket, places like that. I said, I bought my wife a pair of slippers and a vibrator. Oh yes, he said, I said, if you don't like the slippers, you can go fuck yourself. How long you been over here, boys? How long you been over here? Pardon?
10 years.
Well, I suppose you're used to the place now, aren't you? Are you in business at all?
Yeah.
What business are you in?
Markets.
You stand markets? Oh, very nice, that. Lovely. I'm not in a shop yet. That's the next move. Isn't it? That's the next move, isn't it? You've heard about the fellas going round Bradford taking pot shots at Sikhs, and the police have nicknamed him the Terminator. Well, that's what it's all about. this burglar broke into this house. He thought, I'll have that video, I'll have the television, I'll have that nice little grandfather clock. And a voice said, I can see you, and Jesus can see you. No, what the fuck, you know, was that? He turned around, and just a parrot on a perch. He said, was that you? The parrot says, yeah. He says, you frightened me, you're fucking dead then. He said, what's your name? He says, Archibald. He said, that's a funny fucking name for a parrot, that, isn't it? He says, not as funny as that fucking Rockwell of Jesus. This Paddy went up to heaven there, St. Peter come to the door. He said, yes, what do you want? He says, Randy Sims from Rochdale. And St. Peter shouted in there, anybody order a fucking taxi? This Indian went up to heaven, he said, I'd like to come in. St. Peter said, well, it's only for Christians, this place, my old son. He said, well, I give £2,000 to the Christian Aid Society last week. Hang on a bit, he said, I'll go see the boss. He come back, he said, here's your £2,000 now, fuck off. What do you say to these fellas? He said, he's on fucking wheels, you know? Is he on wheels? I'll get you on the way back, pal, don't you fucking put it back. That was the longest piss you ever had, I'll tell you that. Press my guitar on, son. You lucky bastards. I wish you could sit out there and listen to this for you. Certainly. I like to say... No, don't play, Dave. I like to say how happy I am to be with you all this evening. And I'd like to sing you a country song. It's a combination of country and rock. It's called Crock. Here's a little old song entitled Show Me a Home Where the Buffalo Roam and I'll Show You a House Full of Shit. I wrote a couple of songs. One's called You Didn't Want Me When I Wanted You, and now that you want me, fuck you. And they won't publish it, they said the title's too long. So we're just going to call it Fuck You and leave it at that. Release Christmas week, I think. So I wrote another one. It's all about a fella who's waiting for a train to go to Kew Gardens. You know where they grow the lovely flowers and plants and trees and everything in Kew Gardens in London. He's waiting for a train to go to there, and while he's waiting for this train, he's singing my song. Now I should get on top of the pops with this. It's so easy to learn. I want to catch a train. Fuck you. I want a train, fuck you. I don't want a train to Timbuktu. All I want is a train. Fuck you! You know it already. You didn't fucking know that 2 minutes ago, you see. If I don't get on top of the pot of that, there's no fucking justice. As W.C. Fields used to say, the only reason they invented alcohol so ugly women could get a fuck. I bet you suck some fucking stuff in your time. fucking brewery. I'm bisexual, me, you know, if I can't get it, I fucking bite. This doctor says to this fella now, your wife's either got Alzheimer's disease or AIDS. He said, we give a thorough examination. He said, we can't fathom it out. He said, well, what do we do then? He said, well, on your way home in the car, he said, drop her off about 4 miles from your house. If she comes home, don't fuck her. This surgeon went up to this fellow this ward. He says, Mr. Jones, he says, yes. He said, well, I've got a bit of bad news for you. He said, there's another Mr. Jones in this ward, and he's in for a sex change. And we'll give it you instead of him. He said, you haven't got a prick now, you've got a cunt. Fuck it, hell, he said. Does that mean I'll never see another erection? He says, well, you'll see fucking blinking, but it won't be yours.
This is my island in the sun.
The king, the king, the king! What would you get if you crossed George Formby with Eddie Murphy? Now you don't know, Nick. You'd get turned down nice again, you motherfucker. It's all knowledge, isn't it? It's all knowledge. You know why seagulls have wings, my love? To beat the fucking gypsies to the tip. Knowledge is a wonderful thing. What's the difference between Fatima Whitbread's fanny and a cricket ball? Now you don't know, did? In time you could fucking eat a cricket ball. Because if she's not got bollocks, I'll show my ass in the basket. That's the ugliest fucking woman I've ever seen in my life. She'd never pass a dope test, she couldn't get a brick in the bottom. What's it more bald than Ian Botham's back, my love? You don't know, do you? Elton John's fucking chin. I've not had a fuck before you. I'm fucking sick of throwing it over my thumb, I am, I tell you. Some nights you can't think of anybody, you know what I mean, son? Had Bobby Charlton last night, that's how fucking bad things are. Bobby Charlton, that's fantasizing, isn't it? His fucking head kept slipping up the pillow. Anyway, if I get him again tonight, I'll put a wig and a pair of glasses on. Think you'd cheer him up a bit. Could have been worse, it could have been Jackie, couldn't it? He's a right ugly bastard, isn't he? You see, you are what you eat. I'm a cunt. Could be worse if you could fucking arsehole, couldn't I? Have you got my mouth organ there? Let's give him a very good gear. Come on, Pavarotti, let's give him a very good gear. Oh, give me a home. Give me a home where the buffaloes roam. Natty, natty, I don't play. Where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Gentlemen, we'd like to bring a little bit of culture into the club tonight. I do a scene from Romeo and Juliet. The funny scene from Romeo and Juliet. Unlike these actors like Sir John Gielgud, Richard Burton, Laurence Olivier, Marlon Brando, and shit like that, I do it in CinemaScope. In the back of the van, love, it won't be long. There's no chance of giving you one of these later on. Huh? A nose, a nose. In CinemaScope, the scene from Romeo and Juliet, the balcony scene. Thank you very much. I think there's someone in the palace grounds. You what? You
fucking film here. No fucking wages in Romeo and Juliet. Fucking stand by. I said... Six bits of you, twat. 6 fucking pints of bitter. I said... I think there's someone in the palace grounds. Hey! Romeo! Get a fucking deaf aid!
Went to school at 3 years of age, I'll never forget it, because I thought I'd finished at dinner time. She took me back, she said, I've got to go back this afternoon. And I said, oh, I'm not going back, I don't like it. Little did I know, I had 14 years to do.
Anyway, little boy in school says, good morning, teacher. I said, good morning. One said, here's a pencil. She said, you don't speak like that. She said, there's nouns, pronouns, and verbs. Sheila has no pencil, Terence has no pencil, I have no pencils, they have no pencils, we have no pencils. Who's got all the fucking pencils? She says, can any pupil tell me who said, give us the tools and we'll finish the job, a great English station? And this little coon got up, he said, Winston Churchill, 1941. That's very good indeed. And a voice at the back of the class said, send the black bastard home. Who said that? Enoch Powell, 1968. She's writing on a blackboard in a micro mini skirt. She reached up like that when the kids went, drop the chalk, bend down and pick it up, one again. She said, stand up, the boy with the horn. And all the fucking glass.
And he used to sing with the Oscar, Oscar Arabian dance band in the West End of London. I started there. I sang with the Manchester Regiment's dance band in Berlin and Dusseldorf and Wuppertal when I was in the army. Most of the lads in the Manchester Regiment will remember that, that's watching this. Was all national service men, just after the war. I mean, never saw any fighting, only in the fucking Naffy queue. And went from there, I came out of the army, went with the dance band, started putting a few gags in, and one thing led to another. Now I can do a couple of hours on stage without repeating a gag and sing a song, and it's quite easy for me to be funny, it really is. I seem to get a subject and put the gag over and time it well. It's all about timing. You know, you just can't rattle on and prattle on. It's a game you've got to learn over the years. You know, you just can't be a comedian overnight. It's impossible that you know, you just learn the timing, when to slot the gag in, when to say yes and when to say no. And that's what it's all about.
We'll be playing this video in about 300 or 400 years' time, and we'll still be there, won't we? I'll look a rumpkin, won't I, mean? Okay, no. Them fellas are carrying Houdini's coffee once in a bit. He's not in this fucking box.
On the video, you'll see there's elderly people in the audience. They love me having a go at them, saying, you know, talking about the old days when things was a bit rough and we had black-leaded grates and oilcloth on the floor, and some people just had flag blowers and one cold water tap. But I remember all them days. And they get Chinese in sometime, and I had a couple of Japanese in 1 week, and I really went to town on them. We get coloured people in that really are broad-minded. You see, you haven't got to be narrow-minded. This, you've got to laugh at yourself and have a good laugh at everything. Take a joke as a joke. Don't take a joke serious, otherwise you'll live a very miserable life. You really will.
What about the Irish fellow who went to a Ku Klux Klan fancy dress ball as Al Jolson? Unbelievable, an Irish am. It's a pity they can't solve the problem in Ireland, you know, because they're a funny nation, no doubt about that. I don't know what fucking fight about, they're all white. What are you scrapping about? What they want is a million packages rubbing out in the middle of Belfast, you know, they got fucking problems, they're all right. We've got the fucking lot here. Azerbaijanis are coming now. What the fuck do they sell? I never heard of such fucking people.
What would I do if I didn't have the... when the club was burnt down, you know, I can really feel for these people that's out of work and lost their jobs and made redundant. You don't feel for them before. I used to think they're lazy bastards wanting to get a fucking job. But I'll tell you, when this club burnt down, and I used to get up in the morning and think, what are we going to do today? We've got all day and all night with nothing to do. And I tell you, it gets to you. It's fucking awful. Just want to do something. Terrible. So, them that was out of work, you got a feeling for them then, you see. Got an experience to feel for them. You really have. It's like when somebody tells you, my little boy's not very poorly, like, you know, you think, oh, I'm sorry. You know, you say you're sorry. But until you've got children of your own, and grandchildren of your own that's poorly, you realise what they're going through. You do feel sorry for them, and it's heartfelt. You know.
Never let them stop you laughing. I once got sacked for laughing, and they're driving a fucking hearse at the time. The lad says, she's on, where do babies come from, Dad? He said, the stork. He said, who fucks the stork? The lad says, his dad, what we do when my toy's dies, Dad? He said, we get a cardboard box, some flowers, bury it in the garden, get some of your friends around, chocolates, minerals, ice cream. He says, can't we fucking kill it now, Dad?
If you had your time over again, would you do anything differently?
Nothing at all. I don't think I'd start smoking. As you know, I smoke a lot. You see me on stage there, I just throw a few fags. And I like to smoke. And I wish I could stop it. And it's a very bad habit. But if I had my time to go over, the only thing I wouldn't do again is start fucking smoking.
Let's have a smoke, Sonny. A woman went to the vicar. She said, vicar, I must tell you, I lost my temper. This morning, I called the man a fucking bastard this morning. My God, he said, there's no justification for that. She said, well, he put his hands on my breasts. He said, you mean like this? I've not forgotten her, son, I've not forgotten her. She says, yes, he said, there's still no justification for that. She said, would he give me one? He said, you mean like this, when he gets on the job and he's banging away there? She said, yes, please, give me AIDS. He said, the fucking bastard. Fella up in court, the judge says, you're charged with battering your wife to death with a hammer. And the voice in the back of the court says, you fucking shithouse. And it all went quiet, you know. He says, you're also charged with battering your daughter to death with a hammer. And the voice in the back of the court says, you lousy bastard. The judge said, well, this can't go on. He says, come here. Now, he said, I can understand you being a bit upset about this case, but any more outbursts like this, I shall charge you with contempt. Now, what's the idea? He said, well, I live next door to this bastard for over 20 years, he said. Every time I asked to borrow a hammer, he said, he had fucking gone. Fella up in court for stealing an overcoat. The judge says, wasn't you up before me 4 years ago for stealing an overcoat? He says, how long do you think a fucking overcoat lasts? Should I have you anything to say before I pronounce sentence? He said, fuck off. The judge says to his solicitor, what did he just say then? He said, fuck all, Your Honour. He said, I'm sure I saw his lips move.
How would you like to be remembered?
As just the best comic that anybody's ever seen. The best stand-up comic of my era. And I know it will be.
So in a word, how would you describe yourself?
Fantastic.